I grab my bags and I'm heading straight into the store. Gotta be a twister to blow everything down that ain't got the strength to stand its ground. Blow away the dreams that break your heart. Blow away the dreams that tear you apart. Blow away the lies that leave you nothing but lost and broken hearted. Cause the dogs on Main Street out, cause they understand. Of Andrew's amazing victory on Saturday. My name is Richard Miller. This is my wife Dot. We have our Andrew shirts on. This is my son Sam. We play in a band called the Duke Street Kings, and I think this is the biggest crowd we've ever played in front of. I met Andrew many years ago when I had lost a sister to gun violence, and Andrew, when he was the Speaker of the House, had put together a group who was trying to put through some common sense gun laws. And I got to know him back then, and I found out that he was just a great guy. And then came the election a few years ago, and I was all full of energy, all mock and no vector. And I was trying to figure out where to put all that energy. And then I found out that Andrew was running for the Senate to try to take Cory Gardner's seat. And I thought, man, that is where I'm going to put all of my effort. So we got involved with Andrew's campaign, and we've gotten to play a few different things with him. I'm also very involved in healthcare, and I've worked with him on some healthcare stuff. And we're just super excited that he's gaining momentum. Fantastic that he did such a good job through the caucuses. Congratulations, Andrew. Before we sign off for our beginning song, I would like to say that this campaign runs on money. So get out your checkbook if you would. Let's help Andrew get to the next level. Go, Andrew. I'll hand it back over to you, Tara, in studio. Thank you.
Hey, Ranger and Sam, thank you so much for singing Promised Land from Bruce Springsteen. It was a great way to kick off our campaign rally. I'm Tara Trujillo. I'm Andrew Romanoff's campaign chair. I want to thank you for joining us for Andrew's virtual rally to celebrate the great news from this weekend. As Ranger said, we won the state assemblies by 90%. We're so excited, and most important, we could not have done this without your help and support. And we are so grateful for your loyalty and for sticking in with us, and it really paid off. So we're here to celebrate and hear from some of Andrew's endorsers and hear some great music from Ranger and Sam. And with that, I would like to introduce Nick Tuta, the Colorado political lead from the Sunrise Movement. Sunrise Movement came in early and endorsed Andrew, and they have been a huge support to our campaign. Nick, are you there?
Yeah, hi, Tara. Awesome. Thanks so much, Tara, and thank you, Andrew. And thanks, everyone, for being here. I'm really grateful for you all having me here today. I'm really excited to be able to take the next few minutes to share with you all why Sunrise Movement is going all in to make sure that Andrew Romanoff is our next senator from Colorado. So, for those of you who don't know, Sunrise is a movement that formed to stop climate change and to create millions of good jobs in the process. We are composed of ordinary young people working to make climate change an urgent priority across America, to end the corrupting influence of fossil fuel executives on our politics, and to elect leaders who stand up for the health and well-being of all people. I got involved in this movement because, like so many people my age and younger, I am terrified for what the future holds for our generation. We see the climate crisis worsening as the political establishment has been asleep at the wheel. we see the devastation caused by the status quo, which prizes the profits of fossil fuel executives over the air that children breathe when they go to school every single day. We know that incremental change proposed by candidates like John Hickenlooper is woefully insufficient to save our future, and it allows environmental racism to carry on unabated as low-income communities and people of color continue to be the worst impacted by the climate crisis. We also see that politicians like Cory Gardner don't see any problems with the status quo and would continue to sacrifice my generation's future to poison the air that Colorado communities breathe, just so that his fossil fuel executive friends can keep raking in cash at our expense. We have an opportunity in Colorado to reject both of these options that would fail us, and instead to elect a progressive senator who will fight for a Green New Deal, for Medicare for all, and for a society that's centered around the dignity of all people. That's why Sunrise has endorsed Andrew Romanoff, because he is exactly the type of leader who will stand up for the health and well-being of all people. So this race really represents a crossroads for both Colorado and for the country. It's no exaggeration to say that the next senator from Colorado could absolutely be the deciding vote on whether Green New Deal legislation is passed or shut down in the Senate. And to be frank, there's a very clear distinction between Andrew Romanoff and his main opponent, John Hickenlooper, in this primary. Colorado can either nominate an establishment politician who has fought to preserve the status quo throughout his career, or we can nominate a progressive champion in Andrew Romanoff to kick Cory Gardner out of the Senate. When youth activists ask candidates to sign the No Fossil Fuel Money Pledge to take the corrupting influence of fossil fuels out of our politics, Andrew was one of the first to sign. John Hickenlooper and Cory Gardner are the only candidates in the large Senate field who refuse to sign, and both continue to take contributions from fossil fuel executives. Andrew is fighting to save people's lives through Medicare for All, while his opponent killed a paid sick leave bill as governor and still opposes Medicare for All and wants to preserve a system that ties health insurance to employment status. This, despite the fact that 22 million Americans have lost their jobs and many of those Americans their health insurance during a global pandemic. Andrew will fight for a Green New Deal to save my generation's future, while his opponent ran for president on a platform bashing the Green New Deal. The good news is that the people are with us. 93% of Colorado Democrats support a Green New Deal because they understand that with 22 million Americans out of work from COVID-19 and with time rapidly running out to solve the climate crisis, we need bold, aggressive solutions that match the scale of both crises we are facing. We can create tens of millions of good jobs, transforming our economy and our society to work for all people. But in order to do that, we need to elect progressive leaders like Andrew Romanoff. While Hickenlooper and Cory Gardner continue to accept money from fossil fuel executives, PACs, and billionaire special interests, Andrew's campaign is powered by grassroots power across Colorado. What we have working for us to take on these powerful opponents is our people power. Sunrise has a principle that we use to guide our movement. We give what we can. So please take a moment now to think about how you can give to this movement during this trying time. Maybe you're pretty short on time right now, running ragged, but are able to contribute financially so that this campaign can share its message with more voters and compete with the floods of fossil fuel industry cash coming into this race. Or maybe your contribution can be donating time. We need as many people as we can to phone bank. Call your friends, call your family about this race. Let them know that we're fighting for a Green New Deal champion, Andrew Romanoff. Let them know that we can replace Cory Gardner with a senator who will fight for all of us. I'm not gonna lie, this is absolutely gonna be a long and hard battle to win. They have more money and they will stop at nothing to silence us and preserve the status quo. But that is because they are afraid of what we can accomplish when we come together to elect politicians that actually prioritize people instead of corporate interests. We can win this, but it is going to take all of us giving what we can in order to do so. So thank you all so much for being here and for being a part of this movement. I hope everyone stays safe and takes care of yourselves during this time. And I'll, with that, pass it back to Tara.
All right. Thank you so much, Nick. We really appreciate everything that you and the Sunrise Movement is doing for our environment. So, you know, as Nick said, please go to andrewromanoff.com/yes. and contribute to the campaign. We are so grateful for your support, and we would not be here if it wasn't for you. Now I'd like to introduce somebody who just recently endorsed us, Kay Anderson. He's at-large Denver School Board member, and we are so excited, Tay, to have your support.
Thank you, Tara, and it is great to be on Team Romanoff. Looking forward to the day where I can see our first female vice president swearing in Andrew in the United States Senate chambers in January of 2021, because we are going to elect a progressive champion for Colorado and for Colorado's future. And so I met Andrew throughout the 2018 elections, and then also moving into my election as a Denver school board member. And Andrew was somebody who was giving guidance, but also checking in consistently of how can he be supportive in the movement moving forward. And with Andrew's help and with so many others, we were able to conquer the odds and become the youngest African-American elected to public office in the state's history. And so I know the tough fight that Andrew Romanoff has ahead. But together, we are going to make sure that we take out John Hickenlooper in June and we take out Cory Gardner in November. But it is going to be each and every one of us making sure that we're knocking doors when it's appropriate, making sure that we are calling voters, making sure that we are connecting with people via social media, letting people know that it is time for Colorado to make sure we have bold, progressive ideas on the ballot. This is about good schools. This is about healthcare. This is about our future and what our country looks like after coronavirus has passed. But the only way we can do that is by making sure we have a good champion in the United States Senate, and that is Andrew Romanoff. And finally, this is our last time to defeat the most dangerous president in American history. This is our time to retire Donald Trump, to retire Cory Gardner, and we cannot sit by and let the votes continue to go their way. We had 105 million Americans sit out our last election. This time, Colorado needs to be number one in voter turnout. This time, Colorado needs to make sure that they're sending a Democrat to the United States Senate and not Cory Gardner. This is our last chance, and I hope Coloradans will join me to making sure that Andrew Romanoff wins the Democratic nomination, but then also goes to defeat Cory Gardner and make sure that we have our Senate become blue again, and we can finally give Ruth Bader Ginsburg a break and get somebody in there that is going to make sure that her legacy is continued and making sure we have Supreme Court justices that are going to fight for progressive ideas. So I know Andrew's going to get it done, but he can only get it done if you go to andrewromanoff.com and make a contribution of any amount. Well, there's a contribution limit. Make a contribution within the contribution limits and make sure you donate to him, whether that be $1, $5, $20, and Tara will tell you the max so we don't get in trouble. But we are not going to let super PACs decide this election. The people will. So Colorado, I hope you'll join me to make sure Andrew Romanoff is our next United States Senator. And back to you, Tara.
All right. Thank you so much, Tay. I am totally pumped and inspired. And again, as Tay said, we really appreciate your support. So please, andrewromanoff.com/yes. You can contribute 2,800 times two, just 5,600 total. But any support you can give, especially now during this pandemic, is greatly appreciated. So with that, I would like to now go to CD5 candidate Jillian Freeland, who's also just endorsed Andrew Romanoff, and we would love to hear more from you.
Hey, everybody. Good evening. Hope y'all are healthy and safe and all are your loved ones. I am very proud to be the nominee to be for Colorado's 5th Congressional District. And one of the coolest parts of running for office has been getting to hear from the many candidates who ran for the U.S. Senate. And I am so excited to endorse Andrew because I have been continually inspired by his message and by his dedication to working for the people. And the fact that he is the only candidate in this race with legislative experience definitely makes him the most qualified person for the job. And he's up against a big name, but I know that as progressives, we can rally around the fights that Andrew is willing and already taking on. He has been fighting for mental health care access for years. He knows how critical it is to have a universal single payer healthcare system. And I myself am a trained midwife. I have been on the ground working in this system, and I know how critical it is for us to move forward, to make progress on our healthcare system, not just keep trying to fix something that's already broken. I also really respect his dedication to the Green New Deal. This is a crisis that is going to impact every generation that comes after us. I have a 2- and a 4-year-old, and the fate of our planet will be decided before they're even old enough to drive a vehicle. And so knowing that we would have Andrew in the Senate fighting to make sure that we bring down our CO2 emissions, that we transition off of fossil fuels, that we make responsible choices and are very deliberate in the way that we move forward as we change our energy economy. Because he understands that we can generate more good paying union jobs through renewable resources than currently exist through fossil fuels. He understands the urgency of not living in a planet that is one storm after another, because the costs of mitigating these storms and continuing to prop up the fossil fuel industry with all of its direct and indirect subsidies is much higher than investing in renewable resources. Now, I'm in Colorado Springs, and we have an amazing example right here in Fort Carson of how our government has implemented the elements of a Green New Deal on the military base and shown that it is fiscally responsible and that it is possible to get to a net zero energy grid. And so I'm really excited to fight alongside him in Congress, to go to DC and represent the people, because I firmly believe that the US government should be for the people, by the people. And that's what Andrew stands for. Now, as a candidate, I have to make this plug. And here's a statistic that is particularly disturbing. In this country, 90% of races, the person who raises the most money is who wins. And until we can accomplish election reform, we have to invest our time, we have to invest our dollars, and we have to talk to our friends and family members to let them know how critical it is that we have a true progressive representing us in the U.S. Senate. So, Andrew, I am so honored to endorse you and cannot wait to see what you accomplish in the U.S. Senate.
Thank you so much, Congresswoman-to-be Jillian Freeland, everybody. I really appreciate your support. I appreciate so much the leadership that Tay Anderson is bringing every day to the Denver Board of Education. I appreciate the leadership that Nick is bringing, along with all the folks who are part of the Sunrise Movement. And I'm grateful to all the Millers, to Sam, the only vote for the beard challenge that I'll offer in a minute, to Ranger, who is responsible for a special guest we're bringing on Friday, Wendell Potter, leader of the Universal Single Payer movement that Jillian was just speaking about, and to Dot Miller, Arvada Mayor Pro Tem, one of, along with Tay, the 375 elected officials, county commissioners, mayors, city council members, school board members, and legislators who have all signed on to our grassroots campaign. I have so much I want to share with you. I want to start, though, by asking you in this virtual reality, the virtual rally, the several thousand folks who have joined us, to join me in just a moment of silence as we honor the folks we've lost during this crisis. I say thank you for doing that. And thank you for howling tonight. I hope you'll join me in supporting our healthcare heroes at 8 o'clock if you're part of that activity. I know I have been. We've got to do more than howl. We've got to make sure that the folks who are on the front lines of this pandemic get all the support they need, the hazard pay, the personal protective equipment, the training, not just a free pizza and a word of thanks. I was speaking to an EMT just a day ago who said, look, if you want to thank me, make sure that the folks who are driving you to the hospital in an ambulance can get healthcare too. Let's get to a place of universal healthcare, healthcare for all. Somebody asked me the other day why I'm so excited to join this race to defeat Cory Gardner to help flip the United States Senate. And it's because, to my mind, we are running out of time to rescue life on Earth, to repair our democracy, to renew the American dream. If you want a candidate who is satisfied with the status quo, you should vote for somebody else. I'm not satisfied. You heard Ranger point out one of the things we share, as families who have suffered a loss to gun violence. 100 Americans die every day because of gun violence. It should not take a pandemic to put an end to the rash of school shootings we've seen. We know that in the richest nation on the face of the earth, even before this pandemic hit, we were losing 35,000 Americans a year because they couldn't afford to see a doctor. We know that in this world, hundreds of millions of folks, perhaps a billion by the middle of the century, will be forced to flee their homes because of the climate crisis to which we're contributing. We know that the not only the legacy, but the persistence of racism and discrimination in America have created inequities that are vast. And you can see this crisis lay those disparities bare. When African-American families in the United States have on average only a tenth of the wealth of white families, it is no wonder that we have not succeeded in fulfilling the dream that so many have fought and died for. We are not in a place to declare victory, and I will be damned if I will allow us to just go back to normal, because normal wasn't good enough, even before this crisis hit. We know there were too many Americans struggling and suffering and dying on account of problems that we can fix. That's why I'm running. And I'm reminded this every single day by the conversations I've had, even in this virtual campaign, with folks all across our state. I'll share with you a note I just posted about last night on Twitter, a conversation I had with a woman who lives not far from me here in Aurora. She said, "I'm getting to think that people like me don't matter." She said, "You say we're in this together, but I feel like I'm all alone. Nobody cares about me, how far I've come. Maybe I should give up too." She said, "Maybe I should give up too." We should not give up on anybody in America. And I want to just say, if you or someone you love is in crisis, I hope that you will make a phone call to the Colorado Crisis Services Line, to 844-493-8255, 844-493-8255, or text the word TALK to 38255, because we know that among the many casualties of this pandemic, our mental health is at risk. We've seen a ninefold increase in calls to the National Helpline, and we know, as Tay and Joanne have both said, when this crisis ends, we should not return to a point at which 72 million Americans remain uninsured or underinsured, or 500,000 families are driven into bankruptcy by the cost of healthcare. It doesn't have to be this way. It's not this way in other nations. We're spending twice as much as our competitors in other parts of the industrialized world on healthcare that's not often twice as good. So there is so much we can do, but only if we are willing to put leaders in public office in the U.S. House, where Jillian Freeland is headed, thanks to the folks in Colorado's 5th Congressional District, I hope, in the Denver Board of Education, where Tay Anderson now serves, in the Arvada City Council, where Dot Miller is leading us. Put folks in these offices who bring the courage of our convictions to this fight. Now, the good news in this race, of course, is that a dead generic Democrat beats Cory Gardner by 11 points. I'm told, as I'm making these calls, what a low bar we've reached. Folks have told me they would vote for me over Cory Gardner if I were, and I'm trying to count here, a potato, a goat, a trained monkey. I heard all sorts of really flattering comparisons. I'm suggesting you raise the bar. Demand somebody who will bring both a set of legislative skills and a sense of urgency to this fight. Vote as if our lives depended on it, because they do. I want to tell you how you can help us get from here to there. Ballots in this race go out in just 7 weeks. The primary itself is June 30th, but Election Day is more than a fortnight now. It starts in mid-June. And so you are likely to get a ballot in the mail if you are an unaffiliated or a Democratic voter. I say likely because you got to make sure that you are registered with one of those camps. And you can do that by going to the Secretary of State's website. This election is open not just to Democrats, but to unaffiliated voters. All of us will get ballots in the mail. That means about 2.4 million people will decide this election, or at least could, if they return those ballots. I'm going to try personally to reach as many as I can. I have already contacted 200,000 voters in the last 4 weeks myself, and I'm committed to reaching as many as I can before the ballots hit. But I can't do this alone. I need you to help as well. You're going to hear in a moment from Vita and from Irma, some of our hardworking volunteers and staff who can tell you how to join us by texting or phoning voters. And I'll give you a sneak peek. Go to andrewromanoff.com and click on the tab that says Get Involved. I'm going to try to reach 1 million folks. We need 1,000 other people to sign on and help us text and phone as well. You don't have to commit to contacting 1 million voters. Frankly, if you just helped out with 100, that would be a big help. So we need an army of volunteers to win this race. That's the first thing. The second, and you're going to hear this a lot tonight, I'm sorry to say, we need money. Jillian pointed out that we have not yet changed the way that we finance our campaigns. One of the priorities I will bring to the United States Senate and join Jillian when she serves in the House is in changing this kind of pay-to-play politics that's corrupted our democracy. I do not believe we should continue to sell public offices to the highest bidder. If we do that, Democrats and Republicans alike will get exactly the kind of paralysis we've seen, or worse, outright corruption. The reason that we haven't gotten the bold climate action that Jillian and Nick spoke of, the reason we haven't gotten the healthcare reform that we need, as Ranger started by reminding us, the reason that we haven't gotten any of the changes that Tate laid out in Washington is because some of the nation's most powerful special interest groups have figured out a way to just bankroll Congress and block reform. Not acceptable to me, not acceptable to you. It doesn't have to be that way. And it's not just Republicans at fault here. You probably know, if you follow this race, that the powers that be in Washington have been intent on sabotaging our campaign and squashing this primary and declaring the whole race over even before those ballots go out. We need your help to reach those voters in the next 7 weeks. We need to raise $1 million. We could start tonight. We've gotten an average contribution just in the last quarter alone of about $40 a person. There are several thousand people on this call. I actually don't know how many. We had about 2,000 folks register in advance, but then our system crashed for a couple minutes when the website began because so many people went to andrewromanoff.com/live, where you're watching now. My guess is there are at least 2,500 people who are sharing this conversation with us right now. If you're among those folks, if you can hear me, if you can see me, I'm asking you to go to andrewromanoff.com/yes, andrewromanoff.com/yes. If all 2,500 people chipped in $40, the average contribution that we received, and if my math is right, this would be a $100,000 night for us, biggest night of the whole campaign. So I hope you'll help. I am so proud of the team we put together, the staff, the volunteers, the delegates, the supporters who have signed on, and the victory, as Tara mentioned, that we won on Saturday at the State Assembly with 90% of the vote. That's terrific. But we know that a lot more people are going to be making this decision between now and June 30th. So if you're able to chip in some of your time and some of your hard-earned treasure, that would help as well. The last thing I'll say is this, and you probably, if you follow this race, know that one of my opponents, John Hickenlooper, skipped out on 19 of our debates so far. I believe the least you should demand from the person you send to the United States Senate is a willingness to show up and answer questions. We already have a senator who doesn't do that by the name of Cory Gardner. He and Doug Lamborn, Jillian's opponent, I think are in competition to see who can avoid town halls for the longest possible time. It's a close contest. 3 years they're looking at now. So look, I will support John or any Democrat for this nomination if they win the primary and are opposing Cory Gardner in the fall. But I've challenged John Hickenlooper. I'll challenge anybody who qualifies for this ballot to join us in a series of debates. We have 7 weeks before ballots go out. I'm suggesting we have 7 debates so we can put on the table the questions that you and I have been talking about tonight. The climate crisis, healthcare reform. How do you build an economy that works for everyone? How do you reduce the risk of gun violence? How do you repair our broken immigration system? And I want to just close before I turn it back to Tara on that note, on immigration, because it is literally where I began. I would not be here, not just on this virtual town hall or in Colorado. I would not be in America if this country had not opened its doors to my mom and all 4 of my grandparents. I'm the son and the grandson of immigrants, and I'm glad we're here. We are better off, not just as a family, but as a country in every way, intellectually, culturally, economically. We are stronger because we have welcomed people to contribute their talents to a nation that needs them. We don't say that often enough. Instead, we've allowed a president of the United States to demonize immigrants and refugees, to declare the country full, to describe asylum as a hoax, to suggest opening fire on migrant families when they're crossing the border, or at least opening fire lower to slow them down, as he suggested to one of his staff. A president who has caged children and torn families apart, has undermined our moral standing around the world, and dishonored our heritage here at home. And look, we often describe ourselves as a nation of immigrants, but it's obvious we didn't all come by choice. Some came in chains. Some were already here. but we are stronger because of our diversity. It's the secret to America's success. And we need to put in office, not just in the White House, but in the United States Senate and the United States House, a group of folks who are committed to repairing that immigration system and honoring the sacrifice so many families have made. There's so much we can do, just not with the senator we've got. I'd love to have your help. I know many of you have already chipped in to win the Democratic nomination, to replace Cory Gardner, and to flip the United States Senate. So thank you for what you're doing. And I want to say a special word of thanks to the staff. We sent them all home a month ago, so they're all working out of their own isolation chambers there. But to all the team, you're going to meet Irma in a moment, to volunteers like Vida, and to my friend of long standing and our campaign chair, Tara Trujillo in Pueblo, thank you.
Thank you, Andrew. We really appreciate it. And we are so excited. And now, one of my favorite people, volunteer and community leader, Vida Brown from Arapahoe County. Vida, do you want to just talk about volunteering for the campaign? Do we lose?
My thing on mute. Hi.
Oh, there you go.
Hi.
Hi, Vida.
My name is Vida Brown. I'm a retired nurse and I'm a community activist, and I hope out here in Arapahoe, and I hope that everything's safe and healthy and you're practicing social distance and wearing and washing your hands. I really want everyone to know that it's very important, it's crucial that we elect Andrew Romanoff, because Andrew knows how to win. In fact, he engineered the effort to turn our state house blue for the first 3 years. 8 years in the Colorado House of Representatives, and half of that time he was the speaker. As the speaker, Andrew won the endorsement of the opposition leader during that time, which was a Republican, Mike Mayer Parker. So Andrew knows how to work with others across the aisle. The reason why I'm so impressed with Andrew is Andrew has hands-on experience in conservation, mental health, and education firsthand to solve them. More than 50 state and national organizations agreed when they named Andrew as one of the most effective. Andrew knows how to win and how to lead, and he has shown that he is a leader of Colorado and what America is yearning for, a leader who will make us proud. I have a special ask for you. I want everyone that's listening to tell 10 of their friends and family members about Andrew, because this is going to be a campaign that comes down to being done by the people. We are a people-powered campaign. We take donations, but it's going to be very crucial and very important that you volunteer. And you say, how can and volunteer by doing phone calls. I'm retired, so I have lots of time on my hands to do phone calls, texting. And if everyone does what I ask, and we just tell 10 people about Andrew, and then we have them tell 10 people, and then they tell, you will be, it's very important that we get Cory Gardner out. This is the time. The time is now. Back to you, Tara.
Thank you so much, Vida. We really appreciate those words. And thank you for everything you've been doing for years out in Arapahoe County, and definitely your service as a healthcare worker. So now we're going to hear from our staff, Irma Swartz, field staffer for our campaign. She's been dialing away, and before that was really helping to lead with the state assembly. So would you, Irma, tell us what people can do to help the campaign?
For sure. Hi, everybody. I work on the campaign. So just a little bit about me. I came to Colorado to go to CU Boulder, and I fell in love with the state. I'm 24 years old, and every day I face an existential dread about the future of our planet. In the not-so-distant future, there is no guarantee of a habitable world, and in my mind, there is no greater battle than the battle for a healthy Earth. We do not have to submit ourselves to a future of methane gas and flammable water. There is still hope, and that hope takes form in Senator Andrew Romanoff. Andrew is the only one in the race talking about the climate crisis in a productive and meaningful way. This is precisely why we are going to win this race. Colorado is such a fantastically beautiful state. Because of that, it is unique. The people here live here on purpose because they want to live in an environment that is so beautiful. We're ready to send a climate warrior to Washington. So we're in the home stretch of the primary election. We are getting very close to when the ballots will go out, as Andrew said. And we have a chance to choose someone better, someone who shows up and stands up. So I'm asking you today to get involved. The people of Colorado are ready for a progressive leader. They just need to be contacted and connected with. Our campaign is going up against a candidate who is very well funded. Funded by those who wish to do nothing about climate change, those who hate the idea of Medicare for all. Our campaign can win, but only with your help. We are fighting big money with big organizing, and we need you to help us organize now more than ever. I know it can feel scary to call a stranger and talk about an issue that they might not agree with you on, but it is in this moment that nothing is more important than that genuine human connection. That is how we will build this movement. We can't do this alone, so we really need each other. America is changing. We have an opportunity here to be at the front of that change, to be activists and leaders of a new moment in our history. But all we need to do is pick up the phone. Please, if you would like to win this race, if you're ready for a different kind of senator in Washington, if you're sick of corporate interests dominating the way America works, this is the moment to roll up your sleeves and start dialing. Whatever you're fighting for, wherever your passion exists, it is time to use that to fight for change. Colorado is ready. It just might not know it yet. So please go to andrewromanoff.com and sign up right now to make calls with us. Again, that's andrewromanoff.com. You can also join us on our outreach circle and find out other ways to get involved, like within social media. Please join us. We really can do this, but only if we work together. Thanks. Back to you, Tara.
Irma, thank you so much. And thanks for everything you and the staff did to help us win that 90%. It's phenomenal, almost unbelievable, actually. And so thank you, because I know how passionate you are about saving the Earth. And thank you for everything you're doing and literally working and helping people to do exactly that. So thanks for being part of our team. We are going back to Ranger and Sam, because they have a wrap-up song for our virtual rally. And as they get set up, I just want to say again, thank you so much for your support. We would not be here. This grassroots campaign would not be here if it wasn't for you. And again, if you can contribute anything, I know it's a really tough time right now, but if you can go to andrewromanoff.com/yes, it would be wonderful to get that support. So Ranger and Sam, I know you're going to be singing The Monkees, I'm a Believer. Are you guys ready to roll?
I think we're ready. Now, should I take one more minute and just say one more time, get out your checkbooks, guys, because I want to remind everybody that we had a guy on the ground working his tail off to become our next senator and replace this guy who won't even meet with us. When Washington decided that they knew better than Coloradans, and they went and tried to recruit somebody. But we don't need that. We need somebody who's an authentic leader, somebody who's willing to plant his flag and fight for the things that we believe in. Somebody who will come out and meet with us. Somebody who will go out there and get petitions signed, just like we do. A guy who's willing to get out there and, you know, blood, sweat, and tears to win this race. And I know it's a long shot. They got lots of money. We got lots of people. And I don't know about you, but I'm a believer. That diet of its own intuition. You know I saw her face, and I'm believing.
So great to hear some music. Again, guys, follow us on social media, Romanoff 2020, Facebook, the website. Get involved, help us make calls, contribute, and tune in Friday at noon for another virtual town hall where we are going to be talking to New York Times bestselling author and a national voice for single payer healthcare coverage, Wendell Potter. We're going to talk about the importance of Medicare, especially now with the pandemic. So please tune back in, and everyone, thank you again for your support.